Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, Jo Re Mi Fa So La Keto. I'm Jo Re and I'm doing a weekly vlog to share my keto weight loss progress. Although this isn't my first rodeo, I restarted keto on January 4th and have lost over 25 pounds so far. The 75-day plan is done, but I am not. So let's go ahead and see how I did this week. This week I was able to get back on track and get that scale to go back down again. The weekdays are normally pretty easy for me, but it's the weekends where I struggle, if I struggle. This past weekend, Saturday, was hair day for my daughter, and as we know, that can be a several hour long ordeal. So I took out the braids that I had in her hair last time, I detangled her hair, I washed it, deep conditioned it, and then put new braids back in. I did triangle parts this time, and her natural hair is getting really long, right? I can usually get a couple weeks out of this style. And then Sunday was Easter Sunday, so I was really happy that I only had one mini Reese's peanut butter cup and one Starburst all day. So normally Easter was an excuse for me to just eat all the Easter candy. So yeah, only two candies, I call that a win, right? And now for my diet. As I've mentioned in previous weeks, I eat two meals a day and a bulletproof coffee, so I meal prep for three meals a week. I try to keep two of my meals pretty easy throughout the week, and then I may venture out and try one new recipe or one recipe that's maybe a little bit more complicated. The first meal that I made this week was chicken wings and roasted vegetables. I'm a subscriber of ButcherBox, so I get a box of high quality meat every month. Last year, they had a deal where you can pay a one-time fee, I think it was $30 or something, and you would get chicken wings in your box every month for life. It's totally worth it. Every month, the first thing that I make are the chicken wings. It was kind of funny this month. All the wings that I got were drumettes and only one flat. So I don't really know what that's about, but I like the drumettes better, so that worked out. I bake my wings in the oven and I'll leave the recipe below if you'd like to follow that. And then for the roasted veggies, I alternated between Brussels sprouts and zucchini and cooked that in my air fryer. For my second meal, I made a salad with roasted chicken thighs. And this one was really easy. I just roasted the chicken thighs again in the air fryer and then I chopped them up and added them to a salad. And in the salad, I had lettuce, tomatoes, cucumbers, peppers, sunflower seeds, cheese, and then topped it with some ranch dressing. This is a really simple meal to make. All I have to do is just assemble the salad when I'm ready to eat. My third meal for the week was Mongolian beef and cauliflower fried rice. This was actually two new recipes for me this week, and they both turned out pretty good. I've tried to make cauliflower fried rice in the past, and it just never turned out that great. But I ran into another YouTube video by the name of Keto Twins. And they had a trick that they used to make cauliflower rice not taste so much like cauliflower. I'll go ahead and leave a link to that video below, as well as the one where they cooked the fried rice. But if you have not followed the Keto Twins, go ahead and follow them. They have some really good recipes. For the Mongolian beef, this turned out okay. I mean, I don't really think it tasted like Mongolian beef, but it did taste good. And so next time, I think when I make the fried rice, I'll top it with a different meat on top, probably like the Szechuan chicken that Heath and Shelley's made on Hungry Heath's channel. Okay, and on to exercise. My plan is to work out 6 days a week, and I did that. So I alternated between walking and running. So I ran Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, and I walked Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Here are my stats for the week. This week they increased the run time from 1 minute to 1 minute and 30 seconds. So we'll see how this next week goes. I know that they're gonna increase the time again, but I did feel like at the end of the 1 minute and 30 seconds, I was feeling a little bit of back pain. So I don't wanna hurt myself. So I may go back to what I used to do, which was doing intervals, 30-30 intervals, which is basically running for 30 seconds and then walking for 30 seconds and just alternating that. I actually ran an entire 10K that way, And I end up being a little bit faster when I do the 30-second intervals as well. Running is really mental, so for me, it's just like, okay, it's only 30 seconds, you can do 30 seconds. And I think that's what's helped me in the 30-30 intervals. Also, I wanted to add for the virtual 5K, they haven't released the June dates yet, but I should have those in the next couple of weeks. And for those of you that asked, yes, you can walk the 5K. Walk, run, just get the 5K done. So let me know if you're interested if you haven't already. And now for my weight. Da-da-da-da. My current weight is 212.2 pounds. That's a loss of 2.2 pounds for the week and a total of 28.8 pounds so far. So next week, the goal is to hit that 30 pound mark. It's only like 1.2 pounds. I can totally do that, right? Okay, everyone, that's all that I have for the week. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the little bell icon to get a notification every time I post a new video. See you next week. Bye.